The Scania V8 is one of the most powerful engines out there. If you're a truck geek or a driver, you've definitely heard of the V8 at least once in your life. And many, if not all, truck aficionados out there will attest to the fact that this is the most powerful commercially produced engine, with the capacity to produce 730 horsepower. What many may not understand is why this is so. Why and how this Swedish company, Scania, set out to invent this engine. And why did they keep it all these years? Does the world really need an engine that strong, and is it actually selling? In today's video, we'll answer all of these questions. Back in the 1960s, Bengt Gadefelt, the head of design at Scania Diesel Engines, foresaw that there would be a demand for more powerful truck engines in the future, especially for those that would be involved in timber haulage and other kinds of long heavy haulage. As such, the inline 6, 8, and 11 engines that were able to generate 250 horsepower were not going to be enough for the vehicles of the future. Keeping this in mind, they got to work on the engines that would change the future. And so, work began to develop the Scania V8 in 1962. But of course, this wasn't without its challenges, the first being the size of the engine. Since space was a big issue because of the big inline engines, took a lot of space, Scania came up with a 14.2-liter swept volume 90 degrees V8 engine that was first fitted into an LB140 truck, a truck that won acclaim for its power and functionality as it displayed a capacity of 350 horsepower and a torque curve that suited low engine speeds. And the sound of the engine also went around to become very popular. Just listen to that bad boy purr. How could you not be memorized by it, right? Scania manufactured over 170,000 of these 14-liter engines in total, making it by far one of the best-selling engines in the high-output segment. Following this, Scania decided to launch the 4 Series in 1995, but the engineers were undecided on whether they should go with an inline engine that would make full use of a modular system, or a model to highlight the importance of the V8 even more. Finally, they decided to acknowledge the V8's significance to the Scania brand, putting an end to the debate. Some years went by, but soon after the company was faced with the new Euro emissions regulations. This meant that they now had to make some alterations to the Scania V8 design. So, engineers at Scania came with a narrower 72 degrees angle instead of a full 90. 12 prototypes were built surrounding this idea, but the company eventually decided to build an entirely new 90 degrees 16-liter engine. Instead, to solve the crankshaft issues that were being caused by the 72-degree angle. This 16-liter V8 engine created by Scania ultimately replaced the original 1969 V8 engine design and had a capacity that was more than 2 times the original, at 480 horsepower to 580 horsepower. After this success, Scania developed their broadest range of engines in 2005, a feat that hasn't been surpassed till today. These were the Euro 3, 4, and 5 engines that could be displaying the power capacity of 500, 560, and 620 horsepower, with 3,000 Newton meters worth of torque. But it still didn't end there. Scania went on to take a huge development step for their 16-liter engine in 2010, increasing the swept volume of the V8 engine from 15.6 liters to 16.4 liters. And introducing a new and improved lighter yet stronger cylinder block that came with this new unit. And then came the most powerful engine that the world has known, a beast with 730 horsepower capacity and 3,500 newton meters worth of torque that we spoke about earlier in the video. And by far, there's absolutely no competition to this magnificent monster. This engine could also run on biodiesel. It has proven to be a highly efficient engine, but has made the R730 semi-trucks very popular. There was still more room for improvement, so in 2015, Scania introduced the V8 770 horsepower. And the year after came a new generation of V8 engines that were equipped with a more reinforced cylinder block that can handle higher pressures with 200 or more new components, which improved the engine's fuel efficiency. So today, Scania's engines can go from 530, 590, 660, and all the way up to 770 horsepower. And considering Scania Brothers itself with the environment quite a bunch, all these engines can run efficiently on biodiesel. Pretty cool, right? To say the least, Bengt Gadefelt's vision of the most powerful engine finally did come to life, even if he wasn't around to see it. and Scania engineers are still innovating to make the engine lighter and more fuel efficient every day. In conclusion, the Scania V8 is the high-performance benchmark. It's the perfect fit for operations that require the efficiency, power, and performance that only a V8 can deliver. There is no surprise as to why Scania is utilizing their V8s till date. Why bother altering something that isn't broken? Well, that's a wrap for this video. Let us know what you love about Scania in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to never miss any of our future updates. Till then, goodbye.